Welcome back with us here on Leaders of Tomorrow, and we are featuring our Bright Spark segment, show systems as well as BTech innovations. Now, terms like cloud computing, big data, virtualization are no more jargon for Indian enterprises. What's challenging is to integrate these solutions to achieve the desired business goals. On Bright Sparks tonight, we have a 28-year-old company that collaborates with clients to build strategies and make them future-ready. Palomi Mukhopadhyay has the story. Take a look.
India is one of the fastest-growing nations when it comes to IT solutions. And with the rising number of tech needs of companies, IT consulting firms with innovative solutions are taking center stage. Aimed at providing cost-effective and quality IT products, Shro Systems was founded in 1988 by ex-Indian Air Force pilot V.V. Shrotia. Shro offers a bunch of services like enterprise computing, big data, network cloud, wireless, backup and recovery, amongst many.
So give us an idea about the kind of services that you provide at Shro.
If you look at the landscape, there are a lot of buckets in which we do our solutions in. There is workplace productivity, there is campus networking, there is data center solutions. There's the advent of cloud. When you talk cloud, we talk about private cloud, public cloud. We create hybrid cloud solutions. So if you look at customers in verticals like manufacturing, BFSI, education, government, we've got customers in all these verticals, and they rely heavily on partners like us to give them services, solutions, architecting those solutions.
So 100 smart cities by 2020. Do you think a company like yours can contribute to this dream in any way?
Absolutely. I think it's a great phenomenon. If you look at themes like smart city, if you look at like industry 4.0, these are themes in which I think the government is making significant progress. And we as partners, as companies, we are also latching on to these themes because they make a lot of business sense for us. There's huge amount of surveillance projects that are going on across states, and we call it city-state surveillance projects. We are working very closely on those kind of projects, implementing solutions which are networking or storage. To store all the data, to store all the images, they require a lot of computing power. So we are in that business of creating solutions which will drive surveillance.
As an industry expert who has done business for about 28 years now, give us an idea about the compliance-related challenges that you face when it comes to IT solution companies in India.
We look at compliance in many ways. We look at compliance obviously from a regulatory perspective. We look at from internal compliance, from an organization perspective, and then what is required to be done at customer places. And when I talk about internal compliance, I'm talking about culture. I think we believe that compliances at every stage and level will drive a better business growth and a stable company the way we are. If you have survived 28 years through the ups and downs, through the Y2K bust, and through all the various phenomena, it's only because that we are very, very focused on customer delight. We are very compliant as an organization, and we give very, very great importance to customer needs.
With the kind of internet penetration in India and the kind of issues that we are facing with bandwidth, do you think companies can leverage from cloud systems?
It's a great question, actually. If you look at cloud, we are very, very deeply invested in the cloud business, be it public or private. And we see customers across the world, and in fact in India, are going to be using cloud solutions. That's the only way forward. Yes, bandwidth is a big problem, and that's something that is recognized. But as you see companies like Reliance and Tata's and Idea all investing into the 4G technology, 5G is coming in 2020, you're going to see an advent of this huge bandwidth availability, which is going to come across to every city in India. Cloud solutions is here to stay, and I think as a company we feel excited about it because we are in the right position to help customers go either on the public, hybrid or private cloud.
So most IT companies have this concept of work from home. How does companies like Shro help them bring workplace productivity?
Workplace productivity is a great phenomenon. It's a great theme. If you look at companies like us, Shro Systems is looking at it in two ways. One is the device. A lot of people are going to work from home. They require good devices, powerful devices. variety of devices, because again, that's their experience and that's their productivity tool. And I think as Shure Systems, we have this wide range of products now that we can offer to customers, that they can offer to their employees when they say BYOD or they say work from home. And the other part of it is in a, is kind of enabling the enterprises to extend secure connectivity to their work, to the people who are working from home, because that's very important. Because as you work from home, bandwidth, but more than that, I think it's secured connection into their enterprises.
To extend its offering to a larger client base, Shure System has focused on using digital marketing tools to optimize business results.
Shure is an SME, so for us cost is hugely important. So if you go to the traditional marketing techniques like maybe hoardings or cinema slides, they're pretty expensive and they don't reach out to many people. So digital marketing, like be it FB, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, POCC, they help us reach out to a lot of people with not as much as cost as the traditional marketing.
A professionally run firm with 100 plus employees and a strong core team with 7 department heads to push the group's growth trajectory, Shure System aims to provide a total consumer experience for the biggest names in the IT sector.
Living with hearing loss may be an invisible handicap, but Gleetech Innovations is determined to put the spotlight on the world's second most pervasive disability. Pooja Jain has a story for us.